You know what, there are a lot of people out there who like to think of themselves as amateur investigators and police officers. They love this CSI stuff. Well, this is one for you at home, right? Follow the bouncing ball. So this is Lord Lucan. He disappeared in 1974 after his children's nanny was bludgeoned to death. A year later, an inquest found the British aristocrat most likely murdered the woman, but the case was never officially closed.
This is remarkable. Over the past 48 years, there have been dozens of reported sightings, but now a facial recognition expert believes Lord Lucan is still alive and living in Brisbane in a Buddhist monastery.
Wow.
Bizarre.
We're not kidding. Mm. Professor Hussein Agail is the man with the theory, and he joins us now live from the UK. Professor, thanks for your time this morning. We appreciate it. I guess a lot of people are going to go, well, hang on a second, this looks way too far-fetched to be real. We can't show the picture either for legal reasons, but how certain are you that it's him?
As certain as my algorithm can be. The algorithm has been tested thousands and thousands of times, and it's been trained using millions and millions of photos. So it is a very reliable algorithm. We have used it on very high-profile cases, including the Salisbury poisoning case, identifying the suspects, as well as some of the suspects involved in Jamal Khashoggi's case. Mm-hmm. So the algorithm has been used in many, many such cases, and in my experience, it's never been wrong so far.
Does this guy know he's the chief suspect?
Well, he does now.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm here, yes.
Does he know, this guy know, that that you've got him pegged?
I'm not sure. So the story here is that Neil Berryman, which is the son of Sandra, he gave me these photos. He essentially gave me 8 photos. And when I actually started doing this investigation, I did not actually realize who I was kind of dealing with. And this is how these algorithms work. We actually remove the human bias out of the equation. So I was just running those photos, and then it came out to be a match. So in total, I ran 8 photos varying different ages from very young to very old. And all of them came as a match, which is kind of incredible if you think about it.
Wow.
So as far as I'm concerned, I think the photos I analysed belong to the same individual.
So if your theory is correct, Professor, and obviously you've done all your research and the algorithm is proven, how did Lord Lucan escape to Australia, and how does he end up in a monastery in Brisbane?
I don't know. I probably can't answer that question because I was just involved in analysing the face. So for me, it's difficult to answer where he is right now and whereabouts he would be. So it's difficult for me because I was just simply involved in analysing the photos.
So where's the family at? Where are the investigations at? How does this progress further?
So I have given the evidence that I've collected in terms of this facial recognition to Neil, and Neil is currently, I believe, is working on the evidence. He's obviously trying. And I suppose what I've given here is actually some form of closure because I believe he's been working on this case for 9 years.
Yeah.
And this facial recognition, this identity matching, I think would help him to actually at least give him some form of closure on the case. Beyond that, it's difficult for me to say what he might do or what might come out of it.
But you have got no doubts based on the tech?
The photos I analysed, yes, it's a match, and it's extremely likely that it's him in the sense that it could be someone who looks very, very, very like him or an identical to him. Now, these are possibilities, but apart from that, it's a match.
All right, it is fascinating work. Professor, thank you for talking us through it this morning.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Pleasure. Thank you.
What do you think at home? Let us know. Mm.